Testing, testing. All right, cool. And we're back at it again. What is up, y'all? This is your boy Herb coming to
What's
you
up,
live
everybody?
From Forza Horizon 4. Coming to you
live. Going on, everybody. This is Lehns. Also coming from you from Forza Horizon Quattro.
It's Horizon. Today's topic is not as serious, a little more chill for the most part. So, don't tailgate me. The hell's wrong with you? But yeah, so a little more chill, so we figured we'll just cruise around a bit. Maybe we'll do a couple races while we talk to you guys about everything and whatnot. But before we start, I wanted to just have Lehns share a couple words first really quick regarding the Black Lives Matter protests, because we do think that they are very important and the message does need to be heard. Lehns, you want to go ahead and start that?
Yeah, like you said, I'd like to take a moment to talk about the protests that are going on right now. I wish safety to all those who are taking their time, their energy, and money to fight injustice and racism around the globe, because it's hit a global scale, which I'm really happy to see. This is something that we of the Black community have been struggling with for so many years, and I want everyone who can hear me right now to know that we're not done yet. We're fighting for more than just the justice of one man, but for all those who have suffered before us and for those who will come after. Don't go complacent, because that's when they win. The racists, the bigots, the abusers, and the oppressors are waiting for us for the moment that we accept our current reality, because that's the moment that we resign our freedom and our humanity. You know, the only thing necessary for evil to triumph is for good men to do nothing, and that statement has never been more apt. So, to everybody who's out there protesting, stay safe and keep fighting, everybody.
Very well said. Very well said. Yeah, like, this is, it's a big deal. We can't just be somebody who's just swept under the rug. It's very important. That's something that needs to happen. Press forward. We can only better from this if everything is done properly and goes accordingly. As you said, Lehns, we gotta fight for it.
Yeah, it's something that we gotta keep working on. But that's my two cents. I know if you want more coverage on the protests, on everything that's going on, our fellow members of the Metropolis are covering the stories that you need to hear. So definitely tune into them and take the time out to hear what they have to say. Keep yourself informed.
That being said, let's return to our regularly scheduled program. And as mentioned before in our post, we will be talking about Isekai Quartet. Spoiler warning for anyone who has not seen seasons 1 and 2. I know Lehns just binge watched the hell out of them last night.
I mean, like, most of it. I had started before.
Binge watched both seasons last night.
Why you gotta blow up my spot for?
I mean, it's not. Is it blowing it up if it's fact?
Yes.
Listen, man, you waited. I watched weekly. I just watched weekly. I had to wait. You're like, nah, I'm gonna wait till the whole season's done and then just enjoy the whole show.
And I did. And I enjoyed every bit of it because it was hilarious. First off, wait, before we talk about that, where are you?
I'm cruising, bro.
Well,
I'm
like,
just
where? It's
obeying the speed limit.
It is Forza. Why would you ever do anything like that?
Listen, there are rules and regulations. There's laws. There's street laws. I can't just drive all willy-nilly like I want to.
Okay. Okay, my guy.
If I want to tailgate this guy in front of me, I will.
Are you going like 45 miles per hour right now?
60.
Shame. Your
car
is
slower, right?
Way more than that. Okay, your car wants to go fast. Let it go fast.
Car go fast, car go vroom.
Exactly. But yo, When I was watching last night, I could not stop laughing. It was so hilarious. Because it's just a slapstick style comedy. Oh my goodness.
And for those who don't know, Isekai Quartet is literally just a comedy parody using four different Isekai animes into a single series. Which doesn't sound that great on paper, but it works out amazingly.
Yeah, on paper, you're like, what are you talking about? Why?
Let's go there. I just marked a race. We'll go there.
Did you mark it on the group? Did you use the group marking?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
That is the correct answer, right?
I just wanted to make sure.
So the four animes that are fused together are Saga of Tanya the Evil, which I've yet to watch. Eventually, I'll watch it.
I'll let you tell me how it is.
Then there's... I hear good things. I've heard good things. Which is weird, considering the type of character that I think the main character, or at least is affiliated with. It's weird. Anyway, that's another time. That's for another time once I've seen it. Then there's Konosuba, which was already a slapstick comedy of an isekai.
Honestly.
I can't drive. Which is Konosuba is just fantastic. I just haven't seen the movie for Konosuba. I don't know about you, but I haven't
watched
seen the movie yet.
Season 1 and most of Season 2. Because when I found it, right? Because it wasn't recommended to me. I was like scrolling on a list. When I found it, I was expecting something that it wasn't. The description on the website that I was using said action adventure, and that is a complete lie.
It is a complete and utter lie.
Honestly. Ugh, I've never been so lied to in my life. But once I took my time, sat down, I was like, okay, let me give it another shot. I was like, okay, this is actually pretty funny.
Hey, let's
don't I heard you coming too. Bro, can you pay for this car? Do you see what I'm driving, my guy?
Yes. Can you pay for my car?
Yes, it's cheap. It's a cheap-ass car. Okay.
Rude, okay? Rude.
I'm not lying. Other than Konosuba, there's Overlord.
There is Overlord. One of my favorites. One of my favorites.
Overlord was actually really fun.
I guess we'll just do Horizon Presents. That's the only one that's there. So
you can do whatever you want.
Alright, yeah. I'll use the same car I was just using, my S2 RX7 S2 rank.
Okay, dokes, you got it. And then last one.
ReZero.
Yes.
ReZero being the last one with This is the weirdest sound I've heard in an anime in a long time. And just
it is so funny. That. It is absolutely hilarious.
It's just every time something with his Subaru's power of or whenever he tries to talk about his power, just darkness appears on screen and just you hear that noise. It's just like, what?
Oh my goodness, it's such a weird sound that I just started loving it. The first time I heard it, I was like, what? And then every time it came, it just broke down in laughter. Although it is not a funny thing, it is not something that is just to be joked about, because it's actually pretty horrible for Subaru.
It is a pretty dark anime overall. Wow, they're all driving the exact same car. And I mean as the exact same car. No, as each other.
Oh. Well, us against the world, buddy. Oh, it's the same color, too.
That's what I'm saying. It threw me off. Oh, God, these checkpoints are going to be the death of me. So, Yeah, so Isekai Quartet brings them all to the same universe. The story is that apparently they all somehow came across a button that, you know, transported them to this new world, and now they have to live essentially a high school life. I don't know how that works.
Yeah, you have people from, like, completely different backgrounds, some military backgrounds, some who are just, like, heroes, some who are just trying to take over the world. And they now just have to go to school.
And it's like, they can't escape, the school life is mandatory, they have to do stuff like school festivals, school plays, and whatnot. You know, the huge.
Go to class, take tests, get along.
Yep. No fighting. We find out, well, we've known, but Aqua is super racist against undead.
Yo, honestly, like, Levine's alone, man. He didn't do anything to him.
Or the Death Knight. Or Wiz from her own show.
So messed up. She's a quote-unquote goddess, so that's just how it goes, apparently.
She has to purify everybody. I want to point out that I can't catch up to these two in the lead, so I'm going to leave that to you.
Well, I'm way back here, buddy. First, I got to catch up to you. I'm on my way, though.
I mean, as long as I can hold third at least, and you can hold, I don't know, eighth?
I'm in eighth right now.
Then we should be fine. Oh my god. Yo, who's this person just random me? But yeah, it's a hilarious, like, parody of each other's shows, and I really like how they just bounce off of each other. I especially like how everyone who's been isekai'd, once they realize they've all been isekai'd, it's just like, oh shit, you know what I'm going through.
It's like, wow, you know what, I think we can get along, because you know my pain.
Especially Subaru and Kazuma. They're just like, oh, you ever deal with, like, really useless party members? And then Kazuma just, like, looks at his entire party. I wonder what that's like.
Oh no, I could have never imagined how that feels.
Shit today.
It's alright, you'll survive. See, I said I was on my way, and now I'm in sixth, but you know, getting any closer is gonna be a hassle.
It will be a hassle.
Or not.
Oh,
sure. See you, Hunter.
See me?
I see you.
I think, is the race over? Race is
over. Cross the finish line!
Fifth, that's fine. We still got more points, that's all that matters. But, So this anime is just, like Len said, it's just slapstick comedy on top of each other. So it's just, if you like Konosuba, you're gonna like this. I highly recommend you watch all four of the anime if possible, or as many as you can before watching this, because it is, they do sometimes reference other characters from their respective shows, because it's not like, obviously the entire world or all everyone's, every anime's characters added to this new world, the school world. It's mostly just the main characters. So like with Konosuba, it's just the main four, Kazuma, Aqua, Megumin, and Darkness. For ReZero, you got Subaru, Melia, Puck, Rem, and Ram. Then for, what was it? Wow, I'm blanking out. For Saga of Tanya the Evil, you have Tanya herself, and you have her immediate unit. Like her immediate.
The people she commands.
Exactly. Under her immediate command, to the UK, like her squad. Skill and then we also have. Let's know.
Did you say
why?
What do you mean? I didn't do anything.
Did you? Yeah, I saw you hit my car, you jerk.
I don't even see you on the map, my guy.
I'm hitting you. I'm gonna reverse right into you. Damn it, you moved.
Yeah, you're invisible. Out. I don't know what you're talking about. Bye.
And he's out. That being said, and Overlord has Ainz, Albedo, Cocytus,
the Floor Guardians,
Aura, Mare, the Floor Guardians, plus We didn't see them at first, but they were also transported. Hamsuke and that one Death Knight that's like Hamsuke's best friend now.
Word.
Which, I want to point out, I actually completely forgot until recently that Hamsuke, she feels that one of her purposes is to find a mate so that her species will not die out.
I completely forgot that too. What's up, Herbert?
Tilt.
Is that your horn?
Yeah, that was Tilt.
That's so obnoxious.
Yeah, just like me. So. Alright, let's do this one. Go here. Beach View Cross Country.
At the location.
And, yes. Out. Oh, whoops. I keep forgetting to use the group route and not the regular route. Cause
yeah, you don't care about me?
Should be. Shut face. My rearview mirror is underneath my wheel. It's not, and I just crushed it. Great.
Good job.
There goes my rearview mirror.
I do suggest that you watch the shows beforehand because they're pretty good shows.
We can speak for three out of the four.
We can speak for three out of the four. They're of decent quality.
Thanks, Lance.
Why? Well, you are the worst.
We got down here in Bikini Bottom, it's finger strength.
You're ridiculous, you know that.
That being said, we can't speak for four, sorry, three out of the four. In season two, they add another, which is one of Lens's favorites.
Oh, yeah.
Shield Hero.
See, I wish in season two we got a little more Shield Hero.
Yeah, because he actually didn't join their class. He joined the other class. Oh, whoops, that's a tree.
Haha, whatever.
Bitch.
I'm not the one who had the tree. Blame yourself.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Pedestrian vehicle.
Oh, he had a car. Now's my chance. Now's my time.
Is it though?
I go off road, yes.
You mean cheat?
Haha!
Use the road. What happened to following the rules, jerk?
That went out the window as soon as I took up street racing.
Oh my god. See, I'm still following the road out here. See, that's why checkpoints screw you, because you don't want to follow them.
Listen, it's not my fault they put him in like awkward angles, or like the fact that I can touch the flag and it'll tell me, no, you didn't cut through. You didn't get it. Ow. So, what was we saying? Yeah, so we get Shield Hero in the second class, which he has scenes. They, what? Cool
tunes on the fast track. You seen.
Oh, sorry. It came with like, oh, you need to change if you want to earn every reward. You have to change your difficulty from above average to highly skilled. And I'm like, I don't feel like trying right now.
Are you not highly skilled?
Here comes the summer.
Last great race, if you were watching my camera, would just I think explain everything.
All right, fair enough.
Oh wow. Jesus. I have to use these old school cars. Oh. God.
I mean, you technically don't have to use the old school cars. You can choose one of the custom events.
Ugh, I guess I
But I'm know. Down if you are.
No, I can't. The Beach View Cross Country is like it's an actual event. There's no other race here. Or wait,
one day
just
I'll
a normal
teach you.
Event? Oh, there we go. There we go. Oh yeah, this is off-road buggies only. Do you want to do custom? There are no custom events.
I mean, here's the thing. If they're suggesting off-road, the course is going to take us off-road.
Yeah. So we'll do off-road. Let's see what we got. I got an S1 off-road.
I don't have the list in front of me because you didn't start it yet, but...
Oh, sorry.
No, go ahead and
there you go.
Start it up and then.
Yeah, I picked the S1 rank I had. There you go. So yeah. So Isekai Quartet. I think one of my favorite things is that the figures of authority in their respective shows, for the most part, are like the school teachers and the faculty that rule over the school.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So, you know, it's all going. It's just great. Shout out to Wildblood 531. Yeah, that's right. Metropolis, let's get it. We got a message from Hebrew Poppy saying, "My dudes, yo, what is up, Hebrew Poppy?
What's up, my guy?
What is going on?" So, as we were saying, I think another thing that's great is Akko was the first one not from Nazareth to do actual damage to Ainz. It's not canon.
It's not canon.
She was.
She did. I was actually a little surprised that like she pulled that off.
Just what was it, like Turn Undead was her spell or some shit?
Yes. And Ainz was like, that's like a level one spell. What do you think you're gonna do with that? And then he got hurt and he was shocked.
He's like, oh my god, what? Is this... But that, it's funny, because like, that makes me wonder, what level spells does Akko know? If Turn Undead's a level one spell, like, you know,
well,
what
she
I
probably
mean?
Only knows like level one spells.
Up the rear.
Oh
man, I haven't done off-road in a while.
Oh my goodness. It's so different.
Sliding everywhere.
Oh no!
Oh, you missed a checkpoint?
They pushed me out of the checkpoint, dude. It's a wrap for me.
Oh
go
no,
on.
You can make
it's
it up.
My story.
It's still early in the race. You can make it up.
I'll try.
Oh god. Oh no.
You did this to us. You chose off-road.
Oh, I touched the flag. All right, I did shoot off road. This is so rough. And they're so, Jesus. Like, do you have to crash into me? I'm gonna have to start being rude to them.
What? My car flipped over. This is amazing. Well,
your car
no chance
over?
For me. Yeah, no chance for me, buddy.
Oh, damn that. Oh, what the hell?
Lead us to victory.
Okay.
I believe in you.
About that.
What do you mean about that?
About that. About that. Not exactly. I'm still at 7. Oh, wait, I can push this guy out the way. Get out of the way. There we go. Okay.
I almost hit a sheep.
Getting there. Alright. So. Yeah, she was the first one to do it. I think one of the funniest things that Konosuba does that still carries over to Isekai Quartet is, oh no!
What happened?
Damn it!
Now?
I almost missed a checkpoint that might have cost me everything. Why? Oh god! So, oh no! No!
All I hear is oh no's. Oh, this is bad.
Oh,
race ends in 30 seconds. Will I even finish? I don't want a DNF. No! 90%! No!
Oh man. So we got a. Full metal, WRX telling me to do better at driving. Listen, I'm trying, man. I haven't played Forza in months now. I'm so out of touch.
It has been a while.
Yeah.
And he also picked off.
And besides,
it's his fault.
And besides, I'm doing better than Lehns. Why don't you tell him to do better?
Listen, man, I didn't choose the race. All right, I'm subject to your will right now.
Doesn't mean you can't be better.
Yes, it's exactly what it means.
Oh my god. As we were saying, back to topic at hand, is... Oh boy. Actually, here's a question, Lehns. No, let me finish my thought. Jesus, I never actually even finished my thought from before.
Oh my goodness.
With the Escape Quartet, running joke that carries on from Konosuba Tisukai Quartet is, oh man, because we lost, that's it. Like, we can't do anything else.
That's it. What do you mean? What are you talking about?
Like, we lost. It was supposed to be an event, like a series of... Oh, no, that was a different else. Never mind, that was something else. All right, cool. Let's do this one. This is, this one shouldn't be as bad.
I mean, take a look at the restrictions.
It's a B.
Okay.
So
what else?
Shouldn't be too bad. It says car restriction is B700 Mazda.
Have Mazdas?
Oh, wait. You don't want that. That's a dirt racing. You don't want that. Here we go.
I wouldn't like it.
Here we go. Here's a road racing series for you. Car restriction A800, but you need to be only using vans or utility vehicles.
Why do you want to torture me, my guy?
Because it'll be fun.
How is that fun? What is your definition of fun?
Turn around when it is safe to do so.
Don't make me answer that. So, running joke is that it's carried over is how every time Megumin or like Aqua would be like, oh, Kazuma, Kazuma! And just like how in Japanese he'll say, well, it doesn't, they still do the joke in the dub, but it doesn't fully carry over, I feel.
Not the same.
It's not the same.
Turn left.
Because like, I feel like in Japanese, it's just, he always says the same thing. Which is just Kazuma does. And that's the running gag that he answers. Like, why am I?
Haha.
I just realized, why am I going sticking to the road when I have an off-road vehicle? What the hell's wrong with me? All right, here we go. There we go. See? You managed to catch you sliding all the way through the bushes.
You know me.
Alright. I do know you. Is this the one I wanted?
I don't know. Maybe. You told me.
Oh, Jesus. Yo, can you not push me?
No. It's my job.
Son of a... And continue anyway. My convoy. And then...
My team should have updated your schedule for this summer championship.
Jesus.
Have fun out there.
So many races. I gotta buy a car for this?
Uh-huh. So you don't even have a car ready for the event
you
want to do.
What do they recommend? Oh, there's only two. I can only either pick the FPV Limited Edition Pursuit or the Limited Edition Gen F GTS.
Sounds like a garbage race to me.
Yeah, no, we're backing out, we're finding a better race. So, yeah, so that joke doesn't really carry over in the dub as well. It's just like...
But like, why are you watching the dub? It's fine. You don't have to worry.
Lens, are you trying to say that people who watch dub are uncultured?
I'm not saying that they're uncultured, I'm just saying that they're wrong. Right? Very different.
Very different.
Very different.
Extremely. Extremely different. Okay, hold on. Let me change this filter. I need to just take everything off except for new. And we'll do some road racing. We'll do some road racing. Maybe some street scenes. Dirt racing, cross country is also off-road. Yeah, we'll stick with that. That'll be fine. All right, there we go. Oh, look at that. There's plenty of new stuff in the city by Edinburgh. Got plenty of races.
Edinburgh?
Let's check out the... Oh, look. I thought I said Edinburgh. It is Edinburgh. What are you talking about? I'm literally looking at the map. It says, welcome to Edinburgh.
Yeah, Edinburgh.
I hate you so much.
What? We said the same thing.
Oh, my God. Are you one of those tomato-tomato people?
No. If you say tomato... Like, I don't know a single person that says tomato, okay? I don't think that person exists. And if they do, then... They are also wrong.
Fair. As wrong as people who watch dubs? Is that what you're saying?
Not that wrong.
Wow. So dub watchers are very wrong.
Pretty wrong, dude. Although I do have a lot of respect for the voiceover dubbing industry.
Yes. I will say though, there are some animes that do sound better in dub than sub.
Actually,
not,
yeah.
Like, either just
the case can be made.
But I have, I feel like there's not. That's just a solid wall. Oh no, wait. I feel like the case can be made for that, but it really depends on the anime. It has to be like, depends on the setting and the character cast. Like Cowboy Bebop, as a shining example, that the dub sounds fan-fucking-tastic.
Absolutely.
That's number one. You never watched it, but Durarara is another example. But you did see its predecessor, which also was a great example of the dub, and that was Bakano.
Word. Honestly, I just couldn't get into Durarara. I tried.
It's fair.
But it just wasn't Bakano. So.
That's fair. Now, that being said, back to our Isekai Quartet. I feel bad for the Death Knight a lot. Why?
Why not?
Why?
That's a better question. But yeah, why do you feel bad for the Death Knight?
Because Aqua, whenever she gets a chance, is like, turn undead.
Yeah,
it's
the
like,
Death Knight's
turn
pretty
undead.
Abused.
Alright. Let's see. We have a variety of cards to choose from this time, so I'm gonna choose.
My
1997
nice.
GTR. Yep, 1997 GTR. That's what I'm going with. A baby. Probably gonna wreck it right now, because I'm not in driving shape.
Goodness, you were not lying when you said we have a multitude of cars.
Yes, it's pretty much everything, because it's street racing.
I'm gonna be a jerk and pick my Mustang.
Oh my god. He's gonna throw your weight out there?
Throw my weight out there. You know, just a little bit.
But yeah, so the thanks to abuse. Oh, I think a great gag from Isekai Quartet was, what's that knight's name who's really broken from ReZero? That Subaru doesn't call him a cheat
Reinhardt.
Character. Reinhardt. When he starts listing
stupid.
Everything he can do,
oh,
and it's like, oh,
goodness.
He automatically dodges any move he hasn't seen, and he automatically dodges any move the first time he sees it. What?
Yes. Well, it's any move that he has seen.
Yes, sir,
and then
they
he
seen.
Automatically
and then,
dodges if he has not seen it.
Yes. And
I don't know how to
And
be
then there was
guy.
Like a whole list. I need to like tie you. No, I can't. Because anything I do, he'll just dodge. That's it.
He is hanging with Philo.
So.
You right?
Yes, Rex Raptor. Yeah, he is hanging with Philo. And Philo is true adorableness. She's like
Philo's the best.
Personification of a. Of
Philo
a
is the best
chocobo,
chocobo anyone can ask for.
And she talks. And she freaking talks, and it's amazing. Like, I wish I had a chocobo. Oh, Jesus. Oh my god, of course. First thing.
By her
first thing out the gate.
No,
I got you, buddy.
No.
To straighten you out. It straightened you out.
Mm-hmm. Sure, keep telling yourself that. It was sabotage, that's what it was.
You were bouncing off the wall and you came at me.
It was all part of the plan.
Yes. It's all part of the plan?
All part of the plan. Don't even worry about it.
Oh, there. Oh, shit! Damn it. Didn't see that turn coming. Should really look at my map.
Do another turn!
Jesus, this is a tight turn. And another tight one coming up. This very. Like, thank you. Yeah, so chilling with Philo. I like how Sebas and the like older knight from ReZero both just
Wilhelm.
They're like the groundskeepers. Yeah, Wilhelm. They just are the groundskeepers that just chill out drinking tea all the time. Almost like swapping war stories.
They're basically the same person.
Sure. Oh god. Yeah, and there's a lot of interaction between characters that I'm like, this is great. It does
honestly,
sometimes
like, it's the most fun when when you're like, oh, I wonder how these two people would interact with each other. And then you get that. And honestly, the thing I appreciate the most is that when it comes to some of like the really outlandish and like out there attitudes that some of the characters have, the rest of the cast will react the way that we react in real life. So because they become a lot more.
Oh no! Oh my god.
Did you get bodied, dude? Oh.
I got bodied. I didn't miss the checkpoint, but I got bodied. This is just house just appeared out of nowhere. Like it just spawned right in front of me. Alright, cool. Oh my god.
Keep your spot. Don't lose.
I mean, I didn't lose, but still. It's just like, eh. You feel worse for Philo in the cage.
I mean, she wasn't in the cage for long.
She wasn't. And once they saw that she could transform, it's like, oh, you don't belong in here. Now she's a classmate. She's a classmate. But I think one of my favorite interactions with anybody, any character ever, is just whenever people interact with Pandora's actor.
Oh, I can't stand Pandora's actor. Oh my god.
And that's why I love when people interact with them. Like, oh god, why? Which is why when Megumin's like, oh well, Ainz thinks my eye patch is cool. Did he say that? Well no, but Pandora's actor, who apparently knows him well, says clearly it's cool because blah blah blah, and I'm like, oh no, here we go again.
There goes his reputation down the toilet.
Yep. It's funny because like him and Tanya both get along quite well, except when it came down to like what sauce to put on chicken nuggets.
Yeah,
which like, I thought was hilarious.
The three sides were what, salt and pepper, ketchup, and mayo. Right.
Sorry, they weren't. Sorry, they weren't chicken nuggets. They were croquettes. Very different.
No, they were. It was karage, actually.
Is it karage? I thought they said croquettes.
Nah, they ended up getting croquettes afterwards.
Okay. Yeah. So it was salt and pepper, ketchup, and mayonnaise, and I'm like, no.
I mean, no, the spicy mayo that like the Japanese have, that's fire. Like, if it was
that is fire.
If it was that, then we could talk.
I have a feeling that it's not. I really feel like they're talking about
just plain old mayo.
I don't know, man. Just plain old freaking mayo.
Mayo-y. Just straight up mayo.
Not even an aioli, bro. Not even aioli. And it's just why. I will say, when it comes to karage, because the options for me were not there, I was in the salt and pepper camp out of those three camps, if I had to choose.
I was in a fourth camp, honey mustard.
I mean, that wasn't a choice presented by the show.
I don't care. I would have fought all of them.
You would have fought all of them?
All of them. Let's get it.
In a four-way dodgeball game with you by yourself.
Yep. I would lose, but I'd lose standing my ground.
To be fair, you probably could win that dodgeball game simply by just doing nothing.
By dodging.
Because they'd probably take each other out first.
Honestly.
They would probably take each other out first, and then just, it'd be a wrap. Easy win for you, and it's like, ha, honey mustard's the best. I'm out.
Told you I was right.
You hear in the background as you're walking away. Did he even like hit anybody with the ball? Nah, he kind of just stood there.
You generate no threat, and you let the enemies take each other out. That's the way to win.
Just no aggro, no aggro Zero whatsoever, aggro. And you're fine. But it's great. It's great. Overall, I highly recommend it, especially like I said, if you've watched some of the other shows in the past. If you've watched, oh boy, I'm trying not to crash into Lehns and Herb right now. If you've watched the shows in the past, then you're in for a good time. Because you'll just see all the characters you know and love in just a hilarious. Oh god, I went to turn left. Why?
First place will be mine.
Oh, there he goes. Like a majestic eagle.
I got some of my skills back. I better shut up before I jinx it and crash.
But there's three laps, Lehns, don't forget. It's not a sprint.
Three laps, my guy?
Yeah.
I'll keep that in mind.
Excuse me, pardon me coming through. Alright, I'm behind you, bro.
Oh, you're like, the first and second. Look at you. Let's get it.
I'm gonna try to like block this feature for you. So yeah, you watch them in this new setting and it's just nothing but hilarious hijinks overall. I feel like I enjoyed the, what do you call it? Oh no, the grass messed me up to this turn. Oh Jesus.
Don't die, buddy.
I feel like the ending for season one was, I feel like I enjoyed it more than I did for season two. Not saying it was bad, I just feel like what they did in season one had me dying of laughter more often.
I think, you know what I mean? In general, season one was a better season. Yeah, I mean, season two was good and all, but,
oh, God, let's...
It just suffers from the classic trope of just media. Second season is usually not as good as the first. Third season is probably going to be, like, slightly worse. Fourth season has a 50-50 chance of being better than the first season, so, you know, this is how it goes.
Fair. Very fair. I am looking forward to hopefully a third season, which I think they already announced at the end of second season too, didn't they?
Yes, they did.
Yeah, so it's already confirmed they're getting season three. And it's funny because they could actually take this for they could do this for a while, honestly.
Bro, just keep adding setting. Different isekai.
Yeah.
Oh, you saw the hero from Overly Cautious Hero. Overly Cautious for like
yeah,
half
he
a
showed
second.
Up.
He showed up.
He
for
showed
half
up for
a
like
second.
A second. It's like, oh, we should go. This looks like fun. Nah, we don't know what kind of danger there is. We're not ready. And it's just like, we're not leaving.
I'm not going. Oh my goodness, so, I hate that show.
you don't like Overly Cautious Hero?
It is annoying. Like, they tried to throw in a heartfelt, like, story in there, like, towards the end, and I was just like, I guess, but, it's just not
about it.
It's not what the show's about. Oh, Jesus!
You okay back there?
I almost hit you, that's why I said, oh, Jesus.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I touched the grass a little bit. Live.
Yeah, that's why I was like, great. Oh,
look at this race. Look at us. Look at us. What a thought.
Clean
first and second finish.
Clean.
No points for the other team.
None whatsoever. They get nothing. They lose. Good day, sir.
Honestly. I feel bad for them. Not really.
Yeah.
Victory was assured.
Yo. There was another isekai I was thinking that I'm like, I want to see an isekai quartet. Oh! I want to see Slime. I want to see Rimuru and his group just show up.
So I thought that they were going to appear because for the cover of season two, they had what's her face with the mask that Rimuru took her body. Forgot her name.
Oh yeah, I forget her name too, bro.
Yeah, they had her.
But
in
I know
the,
what you
in
mean.
The poster. So I was like, oh shit, we're gonna get Rimuru and Slime. This is gonna be awesome. And then they never showed up. And I was like, you fucking liars! How dare you?
How dare you get my hopes up? Safe to do so. But I think, funny enough, the character I'm most interested in from. Slime to like attract everybody is Bokuta, because he's just a fucking moron.
Oh my goodness, that would be fantastic. He would make the perfect, like, in a show that's filled with how would you describe them, joke characters, comic relief, there you go, he would probably take the cake as best comic relief.
him and that lizard guy who joined their group, who thought that Gokuto was the leader of the, you know, of the place.
Oh, the guy who betrayed his father.
Got a message from Dominic Nesbitt. Nice to meet you too, buddy. Hope you stick around and can enjoy what we're bringing to you. If you do, tell your friends, tell your family, tell your comics. I don't care. Just somebody.
Tell somebody.
just tell somebody. That's my motto. You know, it's like a. I don't know what it's like. I don't know where I was going with that.
I was really expecting something profound, man. I was so
excited.
Well,
I had an idea, but it didn't really apply. I was going to quote Aunt May from, you know, Spider-Man PS4, which is, you help one person, you help everybody.
That's true. So, that's true. It doesn't apply. But it is a fact.
It doesn't apply. It's just going to be a quote. So yeah, I'm hoping Rimuru and his crew show up in season 3 of Isekai Quartet, because this can go on for so long with so many isekais.
Oh dude, I want Log Horizon so people in there. That would be great.
So here's the thing.
Bro, we get the Ninja Turtle?
I think yo, the Ninja Turtle? Leo?
Yeah.
From Log Horizon?
Yes.
Oh my god.
Yes.
Yeah. It'd be great. But I think the Log Horizon people would get along the best with Aynes specifically, because they're in the same idea of, like, I'm trapped in my game.
Yeah.
I'm trapped in my game world.
And I'm sure Aynes misses his guild. And, like, that feeling would make him pretty happy.
Well, I know Aynes definitely misses his guild for the simple fact that, like, he messed that one team up really bad. He was like, oh, your friend sent us here. Your friend? My friend. Alright. What does he look like? He looks like a big guy who's like very intimidating. Like, Alright, did he say anything to you? He's like, yeah. Tell Aynes I sent my regards. And they're like, he said Aynes, huh? Yeah. Son of a bitch. Lying sack of shit.
Fucking liar.
Which, don't get me wrong, I give that team's leader props for attempting. Because he had no idea of knowing that, like, Aynes actually changed his name to Aynes from Monga. He had no way of knowing that.
Roll for persuasion.
Rolled on that one.
Yep.
Rolled on that one, bro. And got his whole team killed. Oh, no. Jesus. Messed up that corner.
Are you not doing so hot this race, buddy?
I messed up one corner. But
I need you up here.
I'm getting... You need me up there? Alright, I'm working on it. Oh, man. Why is that car just in the middle of the road?
Because it's a street race?
That's off you. No, I mean, like, one of the other AI cars was just chilling there in the middle of the road because nobody got stuck on something. Anyway. Jesus. Nope, did not make that turn.
No way. Well, I guess.
Oh, no.
The race is over for me.
You were our ticket to first place.
Apparently.
Okay. We can still get this back.
They're pretty far ahead.
So, we got this. I believe.
I just gotta believe.
Oh boy, here comes the corner I gotta slow down for. That was not the best way to take that corner, but it is what it is.
Well, I finished. Finished in fifth.
Listen, as long as I don't lose my place, we win, so there's that.
So it's really all on you, huh?
Well, there we go.
No,
we won.
Alright.
That's it. It's over. We won. Points matter. Listen, it's like Uncle Drew once said, it ain't about the flash and the style. It's all about getting buckets.
But Herbert, there are no buckets in this game.
That's not playing 2K. It's a metaphor, Lens. It's a metaphor. God damn it.
Oh, man. It's kind of hard to follow there.
Could have just let me have that one, could you?
No, of course not.
Oh, you son of a bitch. Well, I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. Any other isekai you can think of? Do you want an isekai quartet?
Oh, man. Any at all? Let's see. Oh, they can go super classic, like ultra classic, and go with the first isekai, Dot Hack.
Oh, you want to go way back.
Way back.
Oh, man.
We're talking right. Like, what year did that come? Like, mid-2000s?
Something like that. That was
early?
I remember staying up late to watch that, because that was on Adult Swim, right?
Toonami. Well, no, actually.
Oh, it was Toonami.
Yeah, it was Adult Swim. It was on a late night.
Yeah, I remember seeing a Blade. Yeah. I'll be honest, the first time I heard about Log Horizon, I wasn't too interested. Not because of, how to put it? Not because I didn't think it was good, but because there was just, at the time of my age, there was too much talking for me to be interested.
You were too young to appreciate it.
200 yards, yes. Like, I'm sure if I go back now, I'll be like, oh, this is lit. This is fire. But back then, I was like, man, I just want to see them punch something. I want to see them kill something. Just do it.
That's how I felt, too, when I was younger.
All right, this will be our last race for the night.
Oh, yeah? Make it something interesting.
Oh, all right. Hold on, not this. It was a sprint from street racing. Oh, no, not that. All right, let's see. One more race for the night. What are we going to do? Off-road again?
No, please. I mean, if you want to, sure. But I'll hate you for all time.
Oh, all right. Here we go. Here's one. It's a reservoir sprint with modern supercars. There you go. Happy?
I'm never happy.
All right. Fine. Whatever. Whatever. Sure. Why not?
I appreciate you trying.
Anyway. God. You think... Well, it is called Isekai Quartet. You think we'll ever eventually find out where that button came from? Like, you think it's basically just like the source wall for DC, how it's just like, it's just the writers.
You know what it probably is? Is that it's gonna be like the writers, right? Quote unquote. Just giving all of those characters a break from their really stressful isekai worlds. Not really. Have fun. Just like, you guys, it looked like you needed a break. Here's a break. And then they're gonna wake up and it was all a dream. So.
All a dream. Did I mod that car? Fuck it. I'm using it's S1, cap at 900, so I just picked a S1 900 class GTR, which apparently is a pre-order car. I don't like this color, though. Ugh. I should have changed the color on this.
S1 900s. The pre-order one? Ugh.
I'm using that because I hate that color, but...
I have a couple of cars, but all of these are not modded.
None of mine are modded either. So, I haven't touched any of them, which is kind of upsetting.
Gonna whip out the Lambo.
Which one?
Murcielago.
Not the Gallardo?
No.
Sorry, the Gallardo?
Oh, I know Full Metal's gonna hate you for that one.
Oh, yeah. No.
You know, because Marinara runs through his veins.
Marinara! Oh my god.
I'm sorry for his conduct.
Listen, I didn't mispronounce the Murcielago.
Jeez.
Why are you like
Alright, I'm butchering these on purpose at this point. I'm butchering these
I know.
On purpose.
I know.
Yes, Full Metal.
That car is
really,
very weak compared to
really.
Yours.
Yeah, like I said, that's the only reason I picked it, is because it was the highest I could get. Well, I hate the color, though.
I'll
hate
try to
the
keep
color.
Up. Yeah, it's like a weird orange.
Looks like my toilet after a night of Taco Bell. Really?
That,
no comment on
that?
That one?
Is not. I was shocked. I was speechless for a second.
Nothing, man. I expected something.
It's. You just. It can't.
Any other isekais think of? I'm trying to think of like isekais that I also would want. Like you said, you brought up the super old school with Dot Hack.
That was an isekai before we knew what isekai was.
It was. I will say though, there is one other one that I don't want it, but I know it's coming.
Oh
and
boy,
we add it eventually.
What?
SAO.
See, it wasn't an isekai. It's not an isekai though. Anymore. Story wise. Is it?
I mean, it's
because like
it
the
still
first
takes place in quote unquote another world.
I mean, I suppose. But like, it was only the first. Oh my god. Oh no.
First, like, arc.
Yeah, the first arc, he was made a trap there. After that, you know, come and go. Isn't he trapped there now, or somewhere now, or something?
He's in, like, a coma or something, last I checked.
Oh, good.
Yeah, so, like, so from what I've heard from people who actively watch it, because I don't. I stopped after I stopped after season two. I gave it a second season, because I'm like, you know what, I really like the first arc. I didn't like the second arc in season one. You know what? Maybe they can like get me again in season two. But not get me again. So I don't know. We'll see how that goes. This season, people who actively watch it, or at least the new season, they said, "Oh, Kirito's in a coma for some reason." So like, they're like, "Oh, this season's actually really good because." It has almost nothing to do with Kirito, because he's in a coma, and it's all about the other characters. And I'm like, oh, so there's no Jesus Kirito to come save the day? But how will they defeat so-and-so with such-and-such without him?
I mean, that's because he's going to just come back at the end. He'll come back
just
at the
come
end.
In.
Hit him with
damn blitz.
One combo attack. Dude, when I said my car was weak... I was not lying.
I mean, I got first place, so we won. It's fine. We won by 50 points.
I left
points.
It in your hands. You did not fail the city. I'm proud of you.
Oh, my God. Yeah. So, that being said, I can see... Oh, right. This is a circuit? Oh, God. I forgot this
circuit?
Is a series.
Oh,
like,
no.
Like, it's a series. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, no. It's not over.
Until next time.
What do you mean, until next time? We gotta finish this.
We gotta finish this.
My God.
Wait, do we? Or does it just take us to the next race?
Yeah, it just takes us there.
Oh, no.
We're committed.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
If I knew if it was a circuit, I'd pick a different car.
I didn't realize. I'm just like, I just picked a race. So here we go.
I'll bring up the rear again.
Listen, there are other cars that are weaker than yours. So you should at least beat those.
There's one.
There's two of them.
There's one.
It's an 836 and an 837.
Okay, but I got hit into a corner, okay? It was a 2-on-1. I have a slow car. Life is rough. See? Like, you see me? You're just cruising right past me.
I'm just trying to, like, push past everybody. Yep. I'm trying to tailgate all these people.
Draft. laughed harder.
Just distract everybody and you'll be fine. I'll give you the speed boost. Use your nitrous lungs.
What nitrous?
Like, the nitrous. You know, the ones like in Fast and the Furious. Every illegal race car has that, right?
Yep. Also, every illegal race car has two reverse gears.
Yeah. One for reverse and one for faster reverse.
Exactly. That's how cars work, right?
It's like, oh no. No, but it's like, they're going in reverse, and it's like, ah, I think you'll catch me. Let's try and see if you try to catch me once I switch it to maximum overdrive. Hiya! And then, you know, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. Correct me if I'm wrong, it's been a while since I saw the freaking, like, the last Fast and the Furious, but in one of them, didn't Vin Diesel actually, like, with his car in reverse, beat out three other cars that were grappling hooked to his car, something like that?
So I think it was Fast 5, when he was going in reverse, pulling, like, a safe, like, a giant fucking safe, and he needed to go faster, and he switched into his second reverse gear. which is when I, like, fucking flipped my shit. I was like, excuse me? What kind of monster vehicle? I've done. I almost walked out of the goddamn theater. I was so upset. Oh, goodness.
Man. Did you at least, when you picked this race, did you at least pick a Japanese car to honor the title of our video?
I don't have a choice. My car's Italian.
Oh my god. Oh, there are. You don't have to be Japanese to be a Weeb.
That's true. Oh my god.
Just
goodness.
Throw on some anime stickers, some racing stickers, and we give you like an extra. What is it? Extra
Herbert.
2 miles per hour per racing sticker.
Herbert, but there's so many people behind me. They're all trying to hit me.
I believe.
But I'm not fast enough.
Listen, if they try to hit you, just hit them back. Duh.
Once they hit me and they pass me, I don't have the speed to catch up and hit them again.
So don't miss. Yeah, these guys pass me.
Don't let that happen. We need you up there.
I'm trying, man. I think it's one of those moments where they just have better acceleration than I do. Oh boy. Oh, I'm catching up.
No!
Little by little. Oh god! Son of a... Get out of my way!
It's all unraveling now.
Oh, come on! Did I get second? Did I inch that second? No, damn it. We still won though.
No. Okay.
Just hold on.
I was losing control towards the end there. Oh my goodness.
Look, see? You got 7. See?
Yeah, I had to fight for my life for that. Okay? You don't know what it was like back here.
You don't look what it was like up here.
Yes, I do. I know exactly what
it
was like.
How's the weather back there?
Cold. Really cold. Okay? Completely different from up there.
Yeah, it's really hot up here. Humid. 60% humidity. With a chance of heat showers.
A chance of heat showers.
Yeah, it's it's when the rain falls, but it's already hot tub temperature when it hits the ground.
Oh, God. That's the worst. If it's going to rain, at least be refreshing.
Nah, this is that hot rain. The rain just
hot
makes
rain.
Me like, oh man, it's raining? I'm gonna go jump in the rain to cool off. You go outside, why is it hotter in the rain?
Ew. Alright, last race. Here we go.
We got a
Herbert, push me.
So far.
Damn it.
Oh, you tell me that as I'm already like next to you.
Technically, you don't have to win this race, but I am glutton for victory.
Give it to them.
Yeah, we're...
Aha, that guy hit a tree.
If you can make the next guy also hit a tree, that's great.
I'm in fifth, so I'll try.
I'll chill in sixth. Like... seems to be the spot.
Just the spot?
It's the spot. Last lady, so I was in six the whole time, and then this guy let pass me again. Oh. This will be where I am. Everybody asks.
I'm awake. Yeah, baby. I'll play aggressive if I have to.
Ultra aggressive.
Slowly but surely catching up. Oh, tight corner. Nope. Messed up that turn horribly. Alright, here we go. Mello. Our buddy Mello's probably just like, you know, what the hell is Herbert doing? He's probably judging me so hard. I can feel his stare across all these miles.
He taught you better than that.
He didn't teach me anything!
Well, he tried to.
Let me phrase this. He taught me the same way that I was taught fighting games. Get that ass waxed until you learn better.
Exactly. So he taught you. I mean, I didn't say he was a good teacher. He just made the effort. He was just there.
I'll give him that. He was there more than most anime parents are.
Honestly. So good on you, buddy.
Good on you, buddy. Oh, come on.
Should make him a medal.
I got second place at least. Alright, so we didn't win, but it's fine. So, okay, that should be the last race, right?
Oh, yeah. I did my job.
Just chilled in six the whole time?
Just chilled in six.
Full on cruise control.
It was a cruise control. I still had to work.
Oh, man. Well, either way, it's good times, fun times. East Sky Quartet, check that out. But as we said, check out before you do. It's a lot. Like, it's a lot of homework if you want to watch East Sky Quartet and fully enjoy it, which is Overlord, Saga of Time of the Evil, ReZero, and Konosuba.
And then for the second season, Shield Hero.
Yeah, and for season 2, Shield Hero. So in total, you really have to watch 5 seasons of Isekai, which, for me personally, my ranking of most liked to least liked for those Isekai was Overlord, Shield Hero, Konosuba, ReZero, and Tanya is not ranked yet because I haven't seen it.
That's fair. See, mine is a little different. I'm putting Shield Hero at the top, followed by Overlord, followed by ReZero, followed by Konosuba, and Tanya of the Evil just unranked.
See, I can't put ReZero over Konosuba because he made the goddamn wrong choice.
He did make the wrong choice. For that. But to be fair, he's being punished for it. Continuously.
So are we, though.
So we're all suffering together.
Oh my god. I swear, the next time, in the next new season of ReZero, the next time I hear, I'm gonna lose it. I'm gonna lose all my shit. All my collective shit will be gone.
Oh, it'll be great.
it'll be fantastic. So that's the homework if you want it. Look forward. We'll call it here for our Isekai Quartet review, among other things. We diverge a bit on every once in a while. So, watch it. I highly recommend it. Watch the other series that coincide with it, just so you have an idea of who these characters are and what they're like. I feel like the easiest one to get through, is Konosuba, just because it is a comedy. So you can just sit there and you'll just have a great time, you know?
Yeah.
I feel like it's the easiest one to get through.
The most dramatic one is probably going to be maybe a tie between Shield Hero and ReZero.
Oh, yeah. They both have their own share of wow. it's just messed up. So, on that note, as we said, we'll call it here for today. Everybody, don't forget to check out the Metropolis. Check them out. Check out all their shows. Illuminati, RPG Arcade, all the good stuff. They're the ones fully covering the Black Lives Matter protests and everything. So if you want more coverage on the protests, check them out. We will be streaming every week, every Friday, 7 p.m. With a new topic. We'll either change the game up, maybe we'll have a nut, you know, or play the same game. Who knows? We'll try to match the vibe of the game with the whatever topic we're talking about. So yeah, 7 p.m. If you miss the stream, don't worry. We actually will post it on Facebook later, like in a few days afterwards, in case you decide to, you know, want to watch it later on your own time, kind of thing.
Or if your friends miss the stream, you know, send it to them. I'm sure they'll appreciate you for it.
As always, you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter, Simon68_TKE, all one word, all lowercase.
If you want to follow me on Instagram or Twitter, it's LehnsJ, LehnsJ.
So, on that note, sign out for now. Have a good one, guys. Keep it real.